Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We continue with the fourth canto of Ritusamhar, written by Kalidasa. Ritusamharam, literally a garland of seasons, by Kalidasa, the matchless magician with words, unfolds a panorama of the six glorious seasons of India in murals painted with rainbow colors. The poem is rich in erotic images of the humans responding to changes in climate, the extreme heat of summer, the torrential rains, the languid ripening of autumn, the intimacies of winter, and the revival of life during spring. The fourth canto deals with the mild winter that follows autumn in India. The canto has only 19 shlokas. The season itself does not last long. Winter is approaching close by. For Kalidas, while the wheat and barley seeds sprout, rendered white flowers bloom, the rice stalks mature, there is a bond. He says in the first shloka itself that the lotus is visible no more. Vilina padmah prapat tusharu. This is a want which he makes up towards the end of this particular canto. But here one can almost hear Kalidas mourn the temporary loss of his favorite flower, the lotus flower. This is not all. Even women no longer put on garlands, nor do they dye their feet with shalak. Their round hips no longer are wrapped in new silks. They do not even cover their heavy breasts with a fine cloth. Nevertheless, how long can one restrain Kamadeva? The women anoint their bodies with aloe and turmeric. Colorful designs are drawn on their cheeks. The love making is endless. Bitten by their lovers, their torn lips hurt. Writes Kalidas in the sixth shloka. Fatigued by endless love making, these young damsels look pale. A little exhaustion written on their faces. They converse, but do not laugh full throated, even if the occasion demands. Their torn lips hurt, bitten by their lovers. This is followed by an unforgettable image from the poet's inexhaustible repertoire. In the shloka 7, he writes, "The dew drops resting on the tips of morning grass are tears of sorrow shed by Hemanta at seeing the lovers fondling the breasts of their beloveds, at the pain they suffer, those big round mounds so enjoyable to look at." It is naughty as naughty can be. Whom is Kalidas teasing? The women or their suffering golden globes? Halfway into the canto, with the changing season, blue lotus blooms appear. The wives of absentee husbands plan how to flirt, while at the same time show anger, indifference, mana, pride when these rascals return. I'll be discussing only 10 shlokas in this particular video, but one is more colorful than the other. In the second shloka, Kalidas writes, "The playful housewives no longer dress their large round breasts with lovely garlands, or with kunda flowers shining like the moon, looking white as snow, or dye them with red shellac." Look at the mixing of colors. White overridden by other colors. And then he says in Hemant, "The sensuous women do not adorn their upper arms with bracelets, nor the lower ones with bangles, their round hips no longer wrapped in new silks. They do not even cover their heavy breasts with a fine cloth. They are in such a hurry to make love that all these external appurtenances can be taken off in advance. Golden girdles studded with gems circle their hips no longer. The girdles have been taken off. Anklets, musical like the swans, adorn their feet, delicate like lotus, no longer. The feet are delicate like the petals of the lotus flower, but they are no longer adorned with musical anklets. However, they do have Shringara. Getting ready to make love," says Kalidas in the fifth shloka of this canto, "these young women anoint their bodies with aloe, turmeric. On their lotus faces they drop flowers and creepers. They perfume their hair with the Kalaguru fumes. No aspect of Shringar is left out of consideration. Rati Shram Sham Pipand Vakra Samprapt Harsh Abhudyast Arunya." Fatigued by the endless love making, these young damsels look pale, a little exhaustion written on their faces. Parallel to this, the dew drops resting on the tips of morning grass are tears of sorrow. It's a lovely image. The dew drops are tears of sorrow shed by Hemant. The season itself is weeping. He looks at these women and the men and he feels a want. They shed tears, Hemant, at seeing the lovers fondling the breasts of their beloveds, at the pain suffering by those big round mounds so delectable to look at. Looking at the fields where ripe rice stalks dance in the breeze, where herds of deer run and jump hither and thither, looking like jewels where the herons sing, our hearts jump with joy. In this season, writes Kalidas in the ninth shloka, delighted we are to look at ponds brimming with water, cold and peaceful, where the blue lotus blooms, where the majestic swans with a crown glide in languor. The women are waiting for their lovers, their husbands away from home, unhappy in distant lands. The doe-eyed women gaze at the dry roads and await their return. In their minds, they plan their talks on their arrival. How will they flirt and how show mana, that is pride? He can't be given access immediately. He has to wait. He has to placate. He has to explain his absence. Only then the beloved would yield. It's a lovely image. We close here today and we'll take up the rest of the shlokas in this canto in the next video. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you for visiting this site.